Lexi nga Heriki Shahlola. Welcome to our final episode.
Hi, my name is Gilbert Titula. I'm the HID for GRIPS department. Yes, it's my company. I started GRIPS for Life. It was around 1997. It was hectic. Actually, the name GRIPS for Life, I had the vision about the name. That was around 1997. I started this company. I was driving a Mazda 323. I started with a skateboard dolly. I bought a small skateboard dolly, some set of boxes, and I'll fit everything into that Mazda 323. As you know, how small is Mazda 323. But then, yeah, I knew one day I was gonna grow. Actually, there was one of my uncles. My uncle, his name is Robert Sinkwane. Yeah, he was a key grip by then. And then, one day I went there as an assistant. I was just there to assist him. And then, I started developing the love of grips, you know, and then I was like, no, one day I want to be an HOD like him. The film term grips, it's a person who deals with the emotions of the film. Let's say camera setups, rigging, you rig the cameras, the movement. If there's a movement on the camera, it's done by a grips person, because as you know, we lay maybe a track, maybe two or three tracks, and then we'll be moving up and down that track. So creating that move, that smooth move that you get from the camera. And then sometimes you'll rig stuff, like you've got your cranes. You want like your top shots. So yeah, a great person does that. So I always try to be like, not to waste a production time. So I always try to be faster. Add something like, we call it like a bad eye shot. Mm-hmm. You know, the camera can't be on the sky.
Sure.
It has to be there through something like a crane. Like you want to see the whole village, or you want to develop from somewhere. A crane can help you to get those kind of moves. Let's say you start low, and the next minute you are on the other side of the fence.
Sure.
So with the crane you can get such shots, and they are beautiful. They are beautiful shots. Yeah.
Sure.
So the wedding day, it was a great day. It was nice, because you know, sometimes productions, they don't like to hire stuff like cranes, because they believe cranes are expensive, and cranes, it's more like a luxury or whatsoever. But it's good to have things like cranes, to have all those toys that you need, that they will make your production looks good, you know. The value for the thing, yeah. It's a good thing to have a crane on set.
Now, this was the first shot of this beautiful day, this beautiful wedding. There's Tammy up there, and there's Tepo here, my one. And then he's going to be moving the camera guy, because the crane is up. Crane to my camera might hit him. There's a guy far right there. Directly the crane, come down, and what the glorious concern of y'all.
My name is Vonnie, I'm a fashion designer from Vonnie Couture. We designed the main gown for Gian Land of Blood. Actually, the main gown, the mother of the bride, the father of the bride, and the groom's look. I cannot believe it just called peacock. But it's actually like the brief that we got. Mm-hmm. And actually, what inspired the dress was, the inspiration is from a dress that we did last year. Mm-hmm. When we made a beautiful Venda inspired gown for a bride. And then when we got a call, that's what they said, we want something inspired by that dress, but with the Tsonga colors, and add other things, add different beads and all of that, and the color as well. And I have to say, it was actually a challenge and very inspiring to do something that is a bit different, because I've never really done a lot of Tsonga inspired looks before. I think like I'm happy. I mean, we work very hard. A lot of people ask me like, how do you feel? I was expecting the dress to trend. I was expecting the dress to trend because we worked very hard. We had 3 weeks to do all the looks. The father of the bride, which is like two looks, the mother and the groom and the bride's dress, the bride's dress took over 165 meters of tulle, over 3,000 flower petals stitched by hand, a lot of beadwork. So I was expecting it to crash the internet, because we work really, really hard. sleepless nights. We were knocking off after 11 p.m. every single day until we finished the project.
That moment when we felt pride as Tonga people when we saw this on national TV, even the haters, they know that they loved it. They know that they were prideful. They know that they felt it inside.
I had a very long dress and was I afraid of falling? Yes. Anchua, Goa. We had to take a few takes because at some point, Anfampanga go, because I kept being so guarded because I don't want to fall. So they had to reshoot it again because they're like, no, you have to walk elegantly, like flawlessly. And it was so difficult to walk so flawlessly with that dress because it's huge. So it was actually a good idea that Mama Roche, which is a costume designer, she suggested that I wear takis because it healed.
Okay, this is how I felt coming down the long stairs with the beautiful, beautiful dress I was wearing. Oh my goodness, it was amazing. I really, really felt like a princess. I really felt like Cinderella at that moment. Having everyone fuss over you, fixing the dress. It was just so amazing. I loved, loved, loved every moment of it. Just walking down, it just, there's a time where I even shed a tear. I remember like walking down the aisle. For me, more than anything, it was like, wow, this is where I've come. This is where I've come with my career. This is me. You know, I think for a moment, I really wanted to pinch myself and say, wow, is this me? You know, a few years ago, I wouldn't have even dreamt of ever being such a character or playing such a role, or ever being in such a beautiful gown like that while it's work for me. So, oh my goodness. It was amazing. I loved every moment of it.
This was the final shot where she's walking down the stairs when we're branding and exposing the elegance and the glory of Batsonga with one dress that broke the internet.
I think the way we did it was very perfect. And also, we're also living in a world that has a little bit of modernity in it. Batsonga music as well. It's exactly at that point. And I even invited a friend of mine who's become a very good friend of mine from Kiani. You're gonna see him on the show because we wanted to make sure everything that says Batsonga with pride is there. So I think I did capture it according to my best knowledge and the people that were around me helping me to make sure. Bumps are going back again when I called Maponyan because we met once. Fumani showed me a video of Maponyan, like my body went to spasms because of happiness. I'm like, we have to have this guy in the show. And we couldn't find a scene to put him in. And then the wedding came and we had to call him in the morning and saying, you have to be in Johannesburg. And the following morning, I was literally in tears. The following morning, he was there with us on set. And I was just like, oh my goodness. And he's in the episode, which I think is the most beautiful.
Little did she know, but he had a plan. That's how Ruchini has a plan.
It was beautiful because we're showcasing the African culture, Xitsonga. So I think it's a good platform. Giyani is a good platform to showcase such things. You mean Richard Mundau?
No.
He was put in a corner. Tight corner, he had to throw in the towel and... But it's sad, man.
So in real life...
It's painful.
Bumusira would... What would you do in such a situation?
I would never do it. I would never allow it to happen. You know? Why do you force your own child to do things that she doesn't want? Or he doesn't want? That's not right. even
though it puts you in a very compromising
position. It's fine. The lawyer matters. Shouldn't save my time. Of headdress.
Yes.
Ah. Beautiful, man. Beautiful. And you know, the good thing is that the designer comes from the same province that we come from. And he's influenced by some of the traditional stuff up there. It was beautiful, man. Cultural sense. No. I'm gay. I don't have any problem. I like the scene that we did there where I used what's this traditional beer? Upasa to go pass it akensani nawe munna anaranga domwamba ngazina. Hey, he doesn't have a name, that man. So I enjoyed doing that because it's not me, it's not Ndivuo, it's the character Brarich. Yeah, someone's enemy, Brarich. So I enjoyed doing it because, you know, no. I separate me and the character.
Yeah. All in all.
Oh, beautiful! I'm happy. I wish you could go on and on and on, and then we showcase this stuff that we are showing. Ne? And let's have more viewers.
The beauty is seized because the director wanted her to walk up and down the steps a lot, to walk majestically. That's why it looks so beautiful.
My name is Tami Makoki and I'm the DOP of Giani Land of Blood. So something like the wedding day, we had to have a full production meeting about it. You go through like the shooting style, what you're trying to achieve, you reference, and basically you go through like the type of equipment you'd need for that. So the shooting style is basically, it has to be cinematic. It has to be something that isn't something that you see on everyday television. So a lot of things passing in front of the lens, shallow depth of field, we backlight, because that's how you do it on the movie. So basically we had trucks and cranes on the wedding day specifically because you need to break the realm of shooting. So we decided that we're gonna use a certain location which was quite beautiful with the sunrise and it had a lake. So we decided to use the crane so that when we go up on high angle shots, we get to see the landscape and just accentuate the beauty of what we're trying to achieve.
I'm sure we can all agree because this was a killer moment. When Kensana was walking down those stairs, I bet every bride would see herself, was seeing herself in a dress like that. Wow, I wish I could get married in something like that.
I Vitrame Nyele Pikhoza and I play D. Selani Mavasa on Giani Land. I suka. Pele klangen van love. Napsaka la kuru wam chata vukosa. I'm love. And I am love kids. I'm love kava balo. I'm love. So for bo, I chata na vukosa. I will have a mal. Jelly kahle good musa. I have a mal. I'm jelly kahle. So she got what she wanted. Now she's marrying a rich guy because she's a gold digger. Like we all knew. Typical city girl trying to act humble. Bye, daddy. Yeah, I know that Musa loves me and Kensani is just a distraction. You know, she's beautiful, so they say. So she came and distracted Musa. Musa just likes new things, but he'll get over her and he'll be back to me. Yeah, he does a lot. Ouch, Dave. Ouch, one. Mamranza, Shem. Mamranza. Mamranza, Ouch, one. She's nothing like Vukosa. I told you, Vukosa not the Anya, like. Demons, demons. He loves me. One runs. I'm just running. I was alright. Basic. Very typical, you know. Joburg girl, we knew. She likes things. Bright color. Who wears that color anyway on their wedding day? Like, not even yellow, pink. No. She's not a woman.
Well, now you can see, Corey. The crane is moving down and there are also guys there who are actually controlling the crane. The reason they control the crane is because they want a soft, easy movement. And on the stairs, Kasan is going down as well. You can see there's a guy behind. That is Romy, the designer of the dress. So he's also making sure that it stays as peacocky as possible, as elegant as possible, as big as possible. Well, normally this is what is done on weddings where you find there's someone walking behind the bride to make sure that everything looks perfect. So that's what it's doing. Of course, also to make sure that we look as great as possible. Now, the branding, it's a key thing. Branding is a beautiful thing. So that's why we took all this time to shoot this scene. That's why when you saw the episode, the first episode of Wedding Day, you show a lot of beauty there. It's branding. We need to show that the showcase is done in the most beautiful thing as possible. My daughter, she's behaving here.
Now, after all that walking, after all that elegance, after all that glorious, after all that princessness, after all that nganakati, after all that joy that she felt within that beautiful dress, there was one moment that she needed to do. She knows that at the end, she has to walk towards her prince. She has to walk towards the man himself. She has to walk towards the guy, the myth, the legend, the Bukosimoyo himself. Look how she looks at him. Looks how she walks towards him, knowing that, oh, my life has been changed forever. Knowing that my life will forever be beautiful because I'm now married into money. I'm now married into a guy who can afford, not my sakana mayaka baloi. Look at that. Look how she walks towards him. Look at how he looks at her. Now she's a moyo. Now she's the princess Yabukosi.
I mean, I was hired to shoot Bukosi. Because Richard angasula bikori njana le akadla ka late kana na cancer so mina ni vele ni swibona ko mina la mali loko bo nika mali ntsena na dubula ntsena facts live na dubula sweswi na loko mo nika mali nwi na ku ri famba ya dubula nta dubula I magwinya dead eish beside the fact that I messed it up with the ngari kahle bafethu I rikahle swinene from the decors, from michino, michongolo, hinkwaso leswi ya ku ri kahle swinene. It was a life changing experience, I'm telling you. Giyani, I mean, gave me everything. I never thought I could be umagwinya mina. Never once in my life had it crossed my mind ku ri ta tlanga role ya ku dlaya vanhu ni lunghe so. Kahle kahle ni chama boy kahle kahle mina. A ni fani na magwinya.
I'm sure a lot have been asking, how did that bullet come out? Well, they put something called a squib inside my shirt. We had like three set of costumes. What I was wearing there, we had like three sets of those in case we have to repeat the whole thing. So they put the squib inside me and it was controlled via a remote control. So we'll do a dialogue. And there was a guy with a gun as well, someone standing there. So we'll do a dialogue and that thing would go off. And then the gun would go off and then do like that. I was shot. That's how we do those things.